Hi, I've never done one of these videos before. It's an unboxing video. My TV gave up the ghost, and I just thought, you know what? Just get a new one. You could do Facebook Marketplace, eBay, all of that kind of stuff. Anyway, after years of using a flat screen TV, it just finally went blank. You know, I could hear the audio, but nothing on the screen. So here we go. I've got a Hisense Ultra HD TV 4K. And it's 50 inch. That's going to sit perfectly in the slot there. So what's the plan? Unboxing. Make sure that I've got all the components. Rig it together. Put it on the cabinet, and see if it'll run. And the guide said, he just said, as he delivered it, keep the box for 28 days, because if you need to send it back faulty or whatever, you don't like it, you will need the box. So let's just start. Little craft knife. What am I expecting in here? Stands and leads and remote controls, instruction manual, and a television. So I've got two stands. It looks like I've got two slots for screws. So put them to one side. And a television. Take some more of these out of the way. Save them for a rainy day. See if I've not got anything tucked in there. Take no chances. I've got the remote control, leads, batteries, instructions. Have a look at them in a minute. Get the television out. Nice and light. Let's just pop that over here for a second. Right, there's nothing else in the box. So lay the box down. I will use that to support the television for a minute. Good, good, good. Okay. Quite exciting. It's like Christmas, isn't it? Let's get the stands out. Obviously have a certain way of going in. They're not numbered. I've seen some videos have shown that these are stand A and stand B. But having said that, they do look like they have kind of opposing. Yeah, you can see that, can't you? Zoom in. Like the wedgy bits here are different. Good, good, good. Try not to make this as long as possible. So we've got energy certification, how to use Hey Google, which is good because I do have the Google thing at home. European guarantee. What is that? Simplified UK certification of conformity. It's got lots of numbers and a user manual, which I'll be spending the afternoon looking at, but it does show me how to fix the base with some screws. That's good. I'm not putting it on the wall. I don't agree with televisions on the wall because I can't see the logic of sitting on a couch and looking up at a television. Maybe I'm old school. Nice remote control. We'll have a look at that in a minute. AA batteries for the remote, four screws for the stand, power lead, and a audio video connector, which we don't need. Okay, so let's put the paperwork back in the bag. We'll have a look at that in a minute. What we need to do is get the stands, get it plugged in. Let me find a screwdriver. So it's pretty straightforward. I've got two slots there and two prongs here, and the shape of the hole matches the shape
of the leg. So it's just a case of screwing them in and we're almost ready to go. Okay, that's the legs screwed on. Let's have a look at the HDMI connector slots. So I've got a LAN Ethernet, digital in and out, USB 2 serial bus, three HDMI slots. I've got a common interface, card interface front, which seems to be blank. There's some headphone socket there. And that says service, not sure what that is. Antenna 1 and 2. Does anyone ever use antenna 1 and 2 anymore? And we've got another USB. So I've got two HDMIs. I've got my Skybox, which I will put in here. And I've got my Sony Audio Center. So they'll go in there. So far, so good. Now it's just a case of making sure it'll stand. It does stand. Turn it round for you. Looking pretty swanky. It's a case of getting all this paraphernalia off and connecting the power lead and then just connecting it up and then seeing how it turns on and seeing if we can get some kind of picture going. So here we go. What I like about the design of this is that there's no surround plastic. All the flat screen TVs I've had, and this will be my fourth one. First one in the bedroom, second one donated to the kids, third one which I inherited, which is the one that died. All of them had a black or a coloured surround. This is completely flat, so I've got to be careful not to put my grubby paws on it. Right, where's my power lead? Get the power lead ready. Where does the power lead go? I didn't think that. There it is, on that side, which is handy because that's where my plug is, on that side. Okay, let's get the TV over there. I'd say it's quite light. The last one I had was a 40 inch, so I hadn't planned. I think that'll work. Just got to move all the bits and bobs. I hadn't thought about that. You know, pre-prepare yourself. Right. What's on that side? I think that will work. Let's plug the telly in first. Right. That's the plug in place. Oh, look, Hisense. Hey, we've got power. What I need to do is plug in the HDMIs. So I want Sky number one. And I want my Sony home center thing in number two. So that's it. That's really all I've got to do. Plug and play. Two HDMIs. Power is on. I can leave the lamp there because it will give it a nice illumination in the background. You know, kind of that. Select your language. It's looking good. Let's just push it back a little. Yeah, that's looking nice. Should we get the lava lamp working as well? I've got my Sony speakers there. giving me some nice noise. I should put some scented candles on. Right, it's just about the setup now. Get my two batteries. These are the ones that came with it, so I'm just going to use them. More haste, less speed. Quick look at the remote control. Usual setup. Got your channel selectors. You can choose your input. There's the middle OK thing, which we're all familiar with. But look, we can do Freeview, go to Sport, YouTube Music, YouTube, Netflix, all of that kind of stuff. So I'm thinking I'll read the manual because it's going to give me instructions on connecting the television to my internet. And I know that while my Skybox, has got the internet and I can get YouTube and everything from there, I might be able to watch internet stream without using the Skybox. We shall see. Right, follow along. I want English. Oh, look at that. Oh, look, it wants my center, so. Oh, look at that. Straight in. Look at this, it's so easy. It's just plug and play. Everything's working. I don't know if I can put anything on that will demonstrate the F4K without jumping into copyright. So what I'll do is show you one of my videos on YouTube. Lovely stuff, I'm pleased with this. So if I go to my, I want to show you something quite easy for you to do if you're watching one of my videos on my channel on the television, and I then say to you, like and subscribe, but you're watching it on the television. You think, well, how do I do that on the television? Well, this is how you'll do it. So you go to one of the videos.
You know what? One thing I'm discovering is that there are lots of...
So, I'm doing my video, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
And
there's,
I say to you,
tiny clip.
Why don't you like and subscribe? Well, if you... I think it's the up button. Click the pause button. I'm using Sky. However you do it to access this little panel here. You can go to move through, you can like the video while you're watching it on television. You could dislike it as well. You can save it for later. But if you click the icon that says channel, you can then subscribe. Easy as that, right? Well, there you go. Unboxing the new 50-inch Ultra HD 4K television from Hisense. How long did that take? 15 minutes? Easy peasy. Thanks for watching. See you in another video.